In this video, I'm going to give you the tricks you need to feel empowered, sexy, and confident on a date. You see, there are a number of ways women and men approach dating, and yet most fall under these two types, the optimistic dater and the pessimistic dater. The optimistic dater, even with all the craziness and the ups and downs that can come along with dating, still feels a sense of hope and faith around finding and attracting a loving partner into their lives. They know they may need to meet or kiss a few frogs before they find their prince. The pessimistic dater, on the other hand, finds dating a real challenge, and each date or interaction with a man that doesn't go well feels like a huge failure, which sees them falling down a rabbit hole filled with confusion, disillusion, rejection, and perhaps embarrassment over the things they think they did wrong or could have done better, or they simply expect the worst. Feeling emotionally bruised and battered around finding love is not something you can hide, and yet this is the very mindset and attitude that can stop you from attracting the love you want. If you tend to be a pessimistic dater, then this video is for you, because I'm about to show you how you can turn around the angst and disillusion so that you can start feeling confident and empowered in dating again. I also have a powerful free gift to share with you that's going to help you with this topic, so stay with me until the end. Hi, and if you're new to my channel, I'm Nadine Peart, a dating and lasting attraction coach for smart, savvy women and the founder of Healthy You, Healthy Love. Now, before we continue, please be sure to give this video the thumbs up if you like it. Also, I want to find out who you are and what your needs are so I can support you on your path to big, sexy, united love. So please share your thoughts and needs by commenting right below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please click the subscribe button and that bell button to get notified of my next video. So let's get right into it. Here are the three things you can do to feel empowered in dating again. Because guess what happens when you feel empowered with men? You organically become more attractive, because confident people are attractive people. First up is the most important of all. Number one, forgive. Forgiveness is key to finding new love. If all the mistakes you think you made, all the unhealthy relationships you allowed yourself to be part of, or all of the painful things your exes did keep haunting you, then I believe it's time that you dig deeper and start healing the wounds that are still there. Burying your head in the sand and pretending that the pain isn't there is not healthy for you. Harboring guilt and blame eats at your soul, your life force, your joy. If things that happened in the past make you want to cringe and roll your eyes or declare never to love again, then you need to know with every cell of your body that those events are all done. They're over. Sure, they may have hurt at the time, but they don't have to define your future and your ability to find love. I want you to know that people find love every day, even those who thought they never would, which is great news because this means you can too. And this starts with what you do today. It starts with healing and forgiveness. You see, if you haven't fully forgiven yourself, it's hard to believe that you'll ever be enough for someone, and you might even feel like you're undeserving of love. On the flip side, if you haven't forgiven the people you felt hurt by, it will be hard to move on and open yourself up fully to real, compatible love and commitment. I don't believe you need to be fully healed to find love. A healthy, compassionate, and kind relationship can help heal old wounds. And yet, if you know that you're still deeply affected by the past, it will be hard to be confident and feel empowered when you're on a date with a new person. You'll most likely have walls up and believe the next guy you really like will do the same things that were done to you in the past. This can become a self-fulfilling prophecy. You create the very thing you don't want. How do you take your power back? Now, to clarify, to take your power back does not mean to have power over another, for example, a man, or to control someone else. This is about you reconnecting with your inner power to feel empowered within yourself. Be intentional with forgiving yourself and others. This is the only way for you to break this cycle and to feel empowered. Holding on to anger, whether that's directed at yourself or another person, will only hurt you in the end. This will also cloud your judgment of the present and the future. It's really difficult to have your heart available for another person when you're still upset with someone in the past. You have to forgive properly to move on. It's important to acknowledge that not all relationships work out, and not all people, including ourselves, know how to do relationships perfectly. Mistakes will be made. And the truth is, everyone does what they do for a reason, and often it's really not about us. For instance, someone may cheat because they'd rather get attention from another than face their own intimacy issues or the issues within their relationship. Or maybe deep down they don't believe in monogamy and haven't worked it out yet. Either way, if you choose to forgive someone who cheated on you, then you take your inner power back instead of letting yourself being held back by past hurt. Or maybe your ex was abusive, which typically means that that person lacks self-worth and doesn't know how to express themselves with vulnerability and humility. They only feel in control when they're belittling and controlling another. It doesn't make it okay because it's not, and you never have to see or speak to them again, and yet you can forgive them. It may not be easy, though it's possible and helpful for you. If you're on a date and you or your date start speaking negatively about an ex or perhaps something about your or their childhood, well, that's a sign that forgiveness has not taken place yet. The emotional charge is still strong, which is why forgiving yourself and others for their shortcomings allows you to move forward with peace of heart, allowing space for new love. Forgiveness is not about condoning another, it's about letting go of the stories and the meaning you have created about yourself and another. And this is what sets you free. Forgiveness allows for freedom. Which leads me to my next point, number two, validate yourself. Everyone loves a little bit of validation, and we all want to feel desired. This is human nature. However, there's a big yet very subtle difference between appreciating acknowledgement from another and needing flattery and validation to stroke the ego and to calm all of your doubts or fears of rejection. In the early stages of dating, the unknown can make people feel very uncomfortable. When we're attracted to someone, we want to know if they're attracted to us too, because this acknowledgement is encouraging. But if we don't believe we're getting the validation we need to feel safe and wanted, we can feel deflated, unstable, and rejected, which sees us feeling disempowered and acting in ways that can block love rather than encourage love. The way we get our power back is by knowing that in the early stages of getting to know someone, it's important to remember our worth and value so that our expectations are kept in check. When we remind ourselves that we're lovable and worthy of love, we can date with more confidence, which sees us feeling empowered because we know our happiness and our value is not determined by someone else and certainly not by a man you barely know. Of course, some level of acknowledgement is helpful to know whether someone is interested in us, though an empowered woman doesn't need this to feel okay about herself in the early stages of dating. If the man you're dating isn't beaming with enthusiasm, or you can't read if he's interested or finds you attractive, then don't freak out. Some people in the early stages of dating can be slow to reveal what they're feeling. They want to get to know you a little before they start to encourage something romantic, which means if you feel like you're doing something to get validation from him, perhaps texting him a lot, seeking compliments, shopping for a new dress that he will find pretty instead of what you think looks good on you, then rather than looking outside of yourself to feel safe and secure, start affirming yourself from within. Tell yourself that no matter what he says or how he reacts or doesn't react, you are worthy of love. You're beautiful, a good person, and a kind woman. Empower yourself by giving yourself the validation that you're looking for from someone else, instead of engaging in self-judgment and doubt. Also, you'll feel far more empowered when you're clear of what you value in a man. This is the big picture, as this takes the pressure off dating. While you're so worried about what he thinks about you, you may not be paying attention to what you actually want in a partnership, which he may or may not be able to deliver. An empowered woman does not need to convince a man that she's worthy and a catch. Now, I know that this isn't always easy, which means it's time for my free gift. This quiz is perfect if you want to know how to be more confident and sexy around men. If you know you have some emotional blocks and you're not sure how to overcome them or what they even are, then my quiz reveals if you're experiencing one of the most four common romantic love syndromes that blocks love and how to swiftly move past this so you can attract and keep the man you want. The link to my quiz is is right below in the description. Now for the last step. Remember that you don't need a man, you want a man. A lot of people feel disempowered when dating because they feel some shame around why they're still single. If you're single and in your 30s or 40s, there's no doubt you've been asked, why is a girl like you still single? And if you don't have kids, you will get asked this far more. But you have to know that this is social conditioning talking, not your ability to love, not your worth, not your value, because your value cannot be defined or determined by your relationship status. So many people stay in unhealthy relationships because they don't believe anyone else would want them, or for financial reasons, or they're so tired of dating and don't want to be single again. So essentially, they settle with someone who'll do. Now, I can't tell you what's right for you. What I can share is that social conditioning sees people buying cars they can't afford, dressing in clothes or wearing shoes they don't feel comfortable in, working in jobs they hate because it pays well. We are conditioned in all different directions, and your love life or the way you might feel about dating and looking for love is largely conditioned. And this, my friend, sees you feeling insecure and disempowered when dating, and even more disillusioned when things don't work out. So how do you take your power back? Well, you do so by embracing your single status. Sure, you may have some love blocks, even people in relationships have some blocks, and yet this does not mean you can't find love. If someone told you that on average it takes 200 dates to meet a man who you'd be compatible with long term, you wouldn't feel so embarrassed and insecure about your relationship status. And if you meet a man who you thought could be good for you, though he ends up not being a match, it won't affect you so much. Now, I'm not saying it will take you 200 dates to meet Mr. Right, it could be 1 or 50 dates, but I hope you get the idea. True compatibility takes time to attract, create, and find. It's just how it goes for most people. If you're looking for an authentic partnership which is kind, mindful, and passionate, then it's a process of dating, relating, and mating. Some of these prospects work out, many don't. That is, until you do meet someone at the right time who wants pretty much what you want. I want you to feel empowered knowing that you're valuable and lovable single. When you truly feel this about yourself, you'll feel confident when dating, and you won't date men who aren't aligned with your values due to desperation and fear of never finding the right man for you. Sure, some compromise is required because I'm afraid to say unicorns don't exist, and yet you won't settle in the ways that really matter. So there you have it, the three things you can do today to feel empowered and start dating with confidence again. Learn to forgive, validate yourself, and embrace where you are today. Now, before you go, and if you haven't yet, please subscribe, click that bell button, comment, and give this video the thumbs up, and please share it with at least one friend who needs help with feeling empowered again in dating. It's been an honor to have you here with me. I encourage you to mindfully hone the art of self-love and self-honor on your path to big, intimate love, and see you again at my next video.